Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making a peanut butter and banana tortilla roll-up. We did roll-ups recently in Betty's Kitchen. Those were ham and cheese roll-ups using a flour tortilla. And a lot of people have commented on that video and said this is a great idea for a lunchbox or for a party. And they seem to like the idea of doing something so quick and easy that looks a little fancy, and I thought we'll do something for dessert. And the easiest thing would be to use a banana and roll it up inside a tortilla that has been coated with, for example, peanut butter and some other coatings that you might like. So I'll tell you about those as we work our way along. But I'm starting with the same type of flour tortilla. It's a 10-inch tortilla, which actually measures 9.5 inches across. So I'll just put that out on a cutting board. So I'm going to be spreading creamy peanut butter on my flour tortilla. And I don't think with the bananas I have that they're long enough to go from edge to edge. So I'm just going to concentrate on the center. So I'm finishing up with the spreading, and I'm leaving off these two parts because I don't think the bananas I have will reach that far, so there's no need wasting the peanut butter. I'm going to put away my spreader and then concentrate on the next layer. Before I move on, I want to say if you don't like peanut butter, then you could use something like Nutella. Now we're going to put a layer on of your choice, but I've chosen granola. It just came in a cereal box like this, and it says granola, raisins, and almonds. So that is the mixture I've chosen to sprinkle as my next layer. If you don't like that, then you could just use regular cereal of some type that you like. I have tried this with Frosted Flakes, and I put them in a Ziploc bag and used a rolling pin to crush them, and they tasted really good. Now they do have some sugar coating and they don't have a lot of nutrition, so you might want to go with something like just raisins. You could use something like chocolate chips. You could use jelly. You could use marshmallow cream. You just want something that goes well with peanut butter and bananas. So this is a light layer there, but it really adds up when you start rolling. You get a lot of this in any one bite. So now we go to our bananas that we have stored over here, and I do have some lemon juice in the bottom of this dish because I don't want these turning brown before I have a chance to get them taken care of. So I'm just going to lay this close to the edge and pick up the spread tortilla and keep it as tight as possible and roll toward the other edge. And when I get to the end, I'm going to flip this over, and the peanut butter should be able to kind of work as glue, but we know these ends don't have any peanut butter spread or any banana. So now we're ready to cut these in as many parts as you want. So when you get this one finished, then get a serving dish and you can place these so that people see what they're getting. And you can have a mixed bunch on a plate, some that have some maybe red currant jelly in them. That would be pretty. Different types of nuts, coconut, marshmallows, whatever you like. So I'm going to do a few more of these for this plate. Here are our finished peanut butter and banana tortilla roll-ups. And I'm going to take a bite. This one looks nice and neat. It's finger food. It's not messy. Tastes really good. I did put some of my leftover lemon juice on the top of each one of these bananas. I didn't do it on the bottom, but if I were preparing this for a child to take to school, I would wrap them very carefully because bananas, when exposed to air, will turn brown if they're not protected. But this is a really nice treat. It's pretty. It's more like a dessert instead of what we had with the ham and cheese. I think you'll like it.